In this short video, a quick overview of what is capable of a VR design review with 3DPlay native app, 3D experience platform. In this case, we start inside a collaborative space with all the various components used in this project. Now in this case, all we do is use the search at the top to find the correct components, searching just inside any metadata I feel like inside my model. When we find the file in question, in the drop-down, we can choose which app to open up the file with. Now these are the initial apps I'm after. By choosing the More Apps option at the bottom, my compass will appear on the left-hand side, and choose my various apps and which one to open with. Now you'll note there's three different 3D plays here. The one on the left is bespoke Windows 10 version. The one in the middle, denoted by the top right annotation, is the on-cloud version, the web-based browser version. The one we're after here is actually one of the far right. It's actually a native app to refer to it. It's an app that's running locally on your PC. Once I choose it, it will launch 3DPlay on my desktop, and then sync up with the data from the cloud to ensure I have a correct latest version. This might take a couple of seconds. It depends upon the complexity of the geometry, your data speed, or wherever you're using the platform from. Once open, we have the native version of a 3DPlay app. In here, some T-drawings. You can move around, navigate the model, some familiar looking commands of exploding, measuring, doing sections, doing 3D markup directly in the model. Now, for the moment, I've got a HTC Vive Pro headset plugged in. I've also got a Steam VR running in the background. And what this enables me to do is take a more immersive version of this design review. So we can activate on the left-hand side, which scenario I'm after. From here, I have a few options to choose from. So I'll go for my immersive option to utilize my VR headset. Once loaded up, the model will load up inside your VR environment. And the computer itself will show you in mirror what's happening on screen. With the controllers, both options are available. So in this case, we can choose the main activity we're about to do. There are three activities: navigation, explore, and also report. We'll start off with navigation. Inside here, we have three main modes. We can fly by activating the top, my left-hand controller. This allows me to move my controls to move up, down, left and right inside a 3D environment. We also have another way to kind of keep to the ground. In this case, it's the walk functionality. Again, doing exactly the same, but moving around the model. And lastly, for larger models, we have teleport. And this is a great way to move around different environments, perhaps to understand different spatial requirements. Now, we also have two options down here of air grab. If I choose these options, either one of them, to move myself about the scene, or both of them, to scale to make things larger or smaller as required, and even pan around and move around the model. Other modes we can do is explore. And in this, it allows me to hide various components. So in this case, I can see a little bit of Z depth on the side of my submarine. This is because I have two versions of the same file on top of each other, causing the graphics to show in this area. That I can do, my hide option activated, use the trigger so we can hide a component, just moving out a component. This allows me to see perhaps my final design, see a little bit more detail as needed. Other things we can do is perhaps measure. This will let me do a 3D annotation or 3D measure in certain components, perhaps the distance between these two items inside my model. Now this will show on screen, it's been 1.8 meters, also on my controller as well, it's more precise readout. This can simply be hidden very quickly if needs be, resetting the model. We can also change the transparency. So in this case, if I look at the model from the front, perhaps want to hide the main body and show some of the inner components instead. If transparency is chosen, what I can do is select the component there, show some of my inner details. In this case, some of the tanks for ballast inside my submarine. And go a bit further. This time, let's do a section view inside the model. In this case, all I'm going to do is simply cut this in half by drawing a line where I want to cut the model in half. I spin around now to the side, you'll see it's cut through, a nice section view, especially some of the details at the top up here, where I have my hatch at the top. And in this case, it gives me a real kind of idea of the spatial requirement, the spatial area you have to use for the interior, where the pilot would sit inside the submarine. Other options I can use is to explode. And this is a way to use both options together. So I view on top and perhaps look at a little bit more details up here of mechanism. What we can do is activate both triggers at the same time and drag this line out to explode. And also put the model back together again in a certain amount. So this gives me quite a controlled and quite precise way of exploding the components inside. See how things come together, such as the seal at the top. Now it is exploding from the centroid going out to the boundary box. We can, if needs be, bring in various kinematics. If there is an animation, perhaps in some simulation results, into the model, creating different apps. At this point, I'll just reset the model to bring it back to where it was. Now we'll look at markup. Next activity to see what we can do. So this is using reporting functionality inside the software. With reporting, I can create any sort of annotation, any color for my palette on the left hand side. So perhaps want to highlight certain details over here on my model where this headlight is. And I'm actually sketching this in 3D. So the depth perception of your circle here come in. Perhaps we'll highlight this needs to be changing. Again, add any annotation. Perhaps I want to change different size of this to make it either larger or smaller in my final model. In this case, what I can do is just simply write this out for a colleague to review later on outside the model. And again, it's in 3D here, so perhaps I can then grab an arrow with a bit more direction where I'm trying to apply it. Now, this could be a really nice feature of highlighting different items, and the color lets you add different annotations, different items as needed. Now, in this case, what I want to do is perhaps change my render mode, just to show perhaps my hidden details inside my model. Now, with my render mode, I have various different styles. So I can do a little bit of a cartoon view, note the black highlighting around the components in this view. Can change to show the additional lines. Really beneficial in this case, show my sub D, which is the shape of my model and highlight different items. And in this case, I can show full wireframe. So perhaps again, very useful when I move up to the top, to the hatch, and view some of the details and more complex bits of my model. In this case, I'm using my air grabs to highlight in and go in there. So I can see a little bit more, possibly too much of some of this wireframe, what's happening. In this case, perhaps I'll change to a slightly different color, perhaps to blue. Again, highlight something else to my colleagues. Perhaps another change needs to happen down here as well. Again, I'll put a nice helpful arrow to make sure we're pointing it in the right direction. And now that's still there, even when I move back to a different render mode and go back to my model. That's three main modes, the navigation, to move around the model in various different ways, the explore to do section views, to measure and also explode, and report with annotations and other items on the model. Now, if I return back to my 3DPlay app, running rather than through the headset, just through the machine, you know my annotation just wrote there, the size of the front headlight, and also the details at the top have been saved and brought through. So this is a nice way of allowing you to do this 3D markup to fully explore, but be saved back to this document to where we are currently. All these annotations we've created now can be shared. So I'm going to go to the top to share and choose when I'm going to save this. I can share it perhaps with a colleague. I can send it via a messaging app, export it, print it, even share it as a picture as well. In this case, I'm going to choose to publish it to a community, share it with my other design team, and the apps that I'm working upon.